Station, this is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
I'm ready for you, event. Thank you.
Copy that. Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency, this is Mission Control Houston. Please call station for a voice check.
Station, this is JAXA. How do you hear me?
I read you loud and clear. How me?
Station? Yes. So, thank you, Yu-san. So, we will start the interview in Japanese.
We'd now like to start the in-orbit press conference. First, can we ask astronaut Yui to say a few words?
はい、わかりました。本日はですね、お忙しいところ、また夜遅くにもかかわらず、このように集まっていただきまして、本当にありがとうございます。
Yes. 私はですね、First, I'd like to thank all of you for joining me, despite the late hour and your busy schedule. Well, I have been here for more than 2 weeks since I arrived on the Soyuz. Well, looking back, since the launch, liftoff, many people have made...safety checks, and therefore the Soyuz liftoff was quite smooth and successful. And ever since I arrived here at ISS, I have adapted very well to the space environment. I think that this is thanks to the support from many, many people. I'm really thankful for that. Well, I've grown accustomed to this environment after 2 weeks, and I'm working very hard.But astronaut Hoshide gave me some advice that after 3 weeks, you get to be adapted at an even higher level. And I think that around 3 weeks, I will be undertaking this HDV-5 important mission. HDV-5 will be launched and arrive at ISS. And as a Japanese astronaut for the first time, I will be capturing it.And therefore, I think that because I'm adapting to the environment and the work is proceeding very well, and therefore I hope to be able to fulfill my responsibility of this major mission. And then after using the tools here, I would like to carry out a lot of experiments and maintenance work. I will continue to work hard, and please continue to support me.So, I think this is enough for me. If you have any questions, I'll be more than happy to answer them, please. Thank you very much. And now we'd like to proceed to the Q&A. Astronaut Yui, we have about 10 questions prepared. So, those who have questions, please state your name and affiliation before asking your question. Fujimoto from Fuji TV.Well, it's more than 2 weeks since you arrived at ISS. Can you share with us more in detail as to your feelings right now?
そうですね。私自身こちらに来て若干ですね、その宇宙の環境っていうのはまた初めてですから、かなり心配してたんですけど。
Ever since I arrived here, it was the first time that I experienced this environment in space. I was a bit concerned, but I'm physically fit.And because of that, I've been able to carry out my work sufficiently. And whenever I have time to observe the Earth, taking photographs and tweeting. And therefore, I think that I'm finding it very meaningful here. Well, having come here, I'm very impressed with the ISS, the scale of space. So, well, you cannot live in space as it is, but in creating an environment where people can live and carry out experiments in this environment is something that has really struck me. And also observing the Earth is beautiful, but the Earth appears to be very small, and we have to preserve this small Earth. That's how I feel. Thank you.
My name is Suzuki from NHK Television. So on the 16th, the Konotori will be launched, and you will be doing the capture work using the robot arm for the first time. So Dr. Wakata will be working on the ground at the control center, and then you will also be working with the Japanese team in Tsukuba. Any particular feelings about this upcoming effort and how you plan to go into your assignment on the capture? Thank you very much for your interest. I certainly agree. In the past, space development in Japan is about Kibo and HTV, and of course, other Japanese people have come before me. And of course, the control team and the training team have also had achievements. So their performance has been highly recognized by the international space community. And of course, this is a big event that's coming up. The Konotori will be launched, and it will be delivering a cargo. So we will be capturing that over here. I will be the capture assignment, and then Dr. Wakata will handle the go for capture mission. We also have a team in Japan working on this. So I'm really hoping that we can demonstrate what Japan can do as a team, everything that Japan has to offer, because we're proud of what we can do, and I think that it will be encouraging to other Japanese people involved in this kind of endeavor. So, of course, I want to showcase what Japan can do to the world. This isn't the kind of thing that we can do alone. In Japan, however, I think that by showing what we can do, we will be able to elicit more support and cooperation from others, and I think that this will definitely be a big milestone for us. So I'm very intent on being able to carry out my responsibility.
Kanda from GG News. Well, yesterday you tasted the space-grown lettuce. Well, you're from Kawakami, Nagano Prefecture, famous for lettuce. How did it taste? And also this experiment, will this be beneficial for the Mars expedition, which will run for a long time? So was there anything you felt having tasted this space-grown lettuce for the first time? Anything good about it? Thank you very much for the question. Yes, just yesterday we harvested the lettuce and ate it. And it tasted very good. It was fresh, and we don't get to taste fresh vegetables every day. And in the space environment, to eat lettuce that's been grown in space, I thought I was very lucky. And eating the lettuce, I did think about my hometown and also about Japan and also about the Earth. Well, in the future, yes, once there will be the expeditions to Mars and or longer distances, I think that fresh vegetable will need to be grown for the astronauts. And therefore, I think ISS, well, naturally, we are doing research which will benefit Earth, the people on Earth. But also, I think we are also making progress in terms of carrying out experiments for future space expedition. And I think that we have a good balance here. We are serving the Earth as well as other future expeditions. And this is a very good example. I think yesterday was a very good example of what could be done.
My name is Yamakoshi from Shinano Mainichi Daily Newspaper. In addition to Kawakami Village, many people from your home area of Nagano Prefecture are looking up into the skies and hoping for a successful Konotori mission. Can you see your hometown and gazing down on your hometown from high above in the heavens, what kind of feelings are going through your mind? Can you share with us a message for your hometown community? Yes, well, when I saw Japan, and it wasn't just Nagano Prefecture, it struck me how beautiful it is. I said that the Earth is small, and Japan is even smaller. But living in this small country, for all of us to work together, to cooperate, and to live together, and certainly the people who were devastated in the earthquake are now working hard on the reconstruction. So it was very moving for me. I could feel the tears welling up. It was very emotional for me, a very intense kind of inspiration that I felt. Now, my hometown is full of green, it's very lush, and I'm sensing again how valuable nature is to us. From Kawakami Village, my hometown, there's a river called Chikuma River. It flows into the Shinano River, and of course, Seeing how Japan is surrounded by waters, I can realize how important water is to us. That's a great experience. And I've tweeted about my emotions to others. Of course, for the people in Nagano, I appreciate all of their support and encouragement. And I'm just going to sing this a little bit. The country of Shinano is a free country. I'm reminded of this song that praises my hometown area, of course.
Hatanaka NTV, how do you do? Now, you tweeted that you think of the Earth as Mother Earth. At the same time, on Earth, we see that there are a number of people who are thinking and praying for peace. Now, having stayed in outer space, has your thoughts towards the Earth changed? And also, can you share with us your thoughts and prayers for peace?
はい、私自身やっぱり平和の大切さっていうのは本当に私の人生の中でずっと感じてきました。自衛官の頃もそうですし、
Well, I think that the importance of peace is something that I've constantly felt throughout my life when I was at the Self Defense Force and even today. And what I think now is thatISS presence is huge. Well, there are a number of things happening on Earth, but and at ISS, our nationalities mean nothing. We are working together as a single team, working towards a single goal. So I think that this is what's wonderful about ISS. And I think that accumulation of such efforts will lead the way to peace. ISS is, so to say, roadmap towards peace. Well, looking at the Earth from outer space, we don't see any national borders. It's a small planet. You really don't know which country is where, looking at the Earth from outer space. There are no national borders seen from outer space. And therefore, though there are a number of problems, I think that mutual understanding needs to be promoted so that we can create a peaceful Earth. And I hope that we can cooperate towards that end.
My name is Takahashi from TV Tokyo. Your dream has come true to become an astronaut, and now you are at the International Space Station. The first day that you arrived, I'm sure that you were extremely excited, exhilarated. So that first night, were you able to sleep well? And I also would like to ask, what was the first dream that you actually saw in outer space?
はい、どうもありがとうございます。ですね、本当にまあ宇宙に来てのその最初の印象というのはやっぱりこの ISS の。
Thank you for the question.
やっぱり初日はですね、ちょっとやっぱり疲れていたんでしょうね。ずっと
そういう。When I got to outer space, my first impression was I was overwhelmed by how great the ISS is, but I was also very tired because up until then I was very nervous and tense, and of course I had to help with the command center. As soon as we were done with the press interview, we actually all went to bed right away. I was able to sleep really well. It's almost like you're floating on a very expensive mattress. I think maybe I slept for 12, 14 hours. People around me were getting worried I slept so long. The first dream that I saw, and I think I must have felt that I needed to share my feelings with everyone. I dreamed that I was tweeting to others. So then after I woke up, I remembered my dream and then tweeted again. So it's kind of strange, perhaps. My first dream out here was about tweeting.
NHK Global Media Service, Ito here, and I met you in Houston. Well, 6 years ago, when you were selected as the astronaut, 6 years ago, you said that you will take the dreams of 1,000 colleagues with you going to outer space. Can you share with me your thoughts about that now, having arrived at ISS?
私ここにいますけれども、本当にみんなの夢を預かってきてるんだと思うんですよね。
Well, yes, I said this before, but I'm here, but I did bring everyone's dream with me coming here. Well, the reason why I was chosen, I really don't know. Anyone could have been chosen, I think, thinking about the candidates. I was just lucky. And, well, anyone could have come here and taken everyone's dream and realized everyone's dream together. But having said that, I was chosen. And I really want to communicate my feeling to everyone. And I also am determined to make this mission a success for the sake of others. And I will do my best. And once I get back, I will talk to everyone about my experience so that the other applicants will feel that UAE was a good choice. Well, what I promised to my colleagues will be fulfilled, and I would like to prove to them that I did fulfill their dreams.
My name is Saito from NBS. Good evening. When we see the Kibo rack, it looks quite busy. And what are the experiments that you're looking forward to? Also about living at ISS and then how that balances out with your experiment work, please tell us about that.
希望もですね、本当にたくさんの実験機材が並んでいて、これを使って実験するの非常に楽しみなんですけど。
Thank you for the question.
私自身ですね、
Being in Kibo, there's a lot of experimental devices, and I'm really looking forward to working with these devices. One thing I'm personally looking forward to, I was always interested in astrology.So, when the HTV gets here, we will be able to observe outer space. And I'm very interested in understanding that further with the CALET. Ultimately, at Kibo, we are planning on doing an experiment to have some small animals. So, I will be assembling the device, and then I need to make sure that it will function.properly, which is an important piece of work, so I'm looking forward to that. Living at ISS, it's very busy. We have a minute-by-minute schedule. And then Saturdays and Sundays, so I have maybe half a day off on Saturday, and then on Sunday, usually I don't have a lot of tasks, so I spend my personal time taking photographs, tweeting, and...using my personal time for my hobby, which is taking photographs and tweeting about it.
Thank you. Lastly, astronaut Yui, can you share with us your aspiration for the remainder of your mission? And please also give a message to the Japanese people.
はい、本当にですね、私自身ツイッターも読んでますし、ニュースもちょっと見ることができるんですけれども、インターネットなので。
Yes, I am reading tweets and also looking at the internet news, and I really feel strongly the expectations held towards me by the Japanese people. I really have to produce results.Because I think this will lead the way to the future of Japan's space activities, and I think I need to showcase what Japan can do to the international community and also live up to the expectation of the Japanese people. I'm slow, like a turtle, but I am working hard, and I know it's hot there, so I hope that you'll stay fit. Thank you.Thank you very much. And with this, we would like to conclude the in-orbit press conference. Thank you.
どうもありがとうございました。
Station, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the event. Thank you.